Hi Vijay, vanakkam.
Vanakkam Prashant.
Welcome to Chennai, Tamil Nadu.
Thank you so much.
We have been hearing a lot about you. Forget about all the film and all that. Being a human being, you know, you always make some special style statements every now and then. You know, whenever I see a photo of you, this guy is wearing a lungi and then a shoe. What is this guy thinking even? See, you are just not even 30. You are holding huge weight on your shoulders as a star, as a human being. Did you ever think that, you know, before 4 years I'll become a huge star and, you know, there'll be so much fan base, you know, I'll be riding this wave and all that?
The thing is, there are moments where you know that you will be big. There are moments I've known that you're meant for something really big, just work. But there are also moments where you have doubt, where you think nothing's going to happen. I think it's very normal for all of us to go through these moments that, array, I'm going to hit this big time. Also moments where I think nothing will happen, and it's just about doing your best, doing what you like, doing it right to the best of your effort. So whatever I've done, I give it my all, and I work hard, I work smart.
To compare, we have Vijay Sethupathi here.
Okay.
His roots, his growth, his graph.
Okay.
It kind of matches your thing.
Okay.
You know, he came from a strong root, you know, wherein he acted in a lot of short films.
Okay.
He associated with a lot of small time filmmakers.
Okay.
And then, you know, he stepped up and his game is different now.
Okay.
It has gone to the next level.
Okay.
I personally think that you are gifted with the teams, be it Pelli Chuppulu or be it Arjun Reddy.
Yeah.
These are small movies with a big heart.
Yeah, yeah.
And that's why I think you have jumped to this level.
Yeah.
Do you think the thing that the team happened automatically, or it's God's will? Of
I was doing Yavade Subramanyam, and I was working with this director called Nagashwin, and I wanted to work with a bunch of good new directors, and I knew that I need to find people like me who will give me work. I happened to watch Tarun's films. I happened to watch another boy called Bharat Kamma's short films. I really liked them. So I went and met them. I wrote to them. I said, I want to work with you guys. I was no one then.
Okay.
We spoke and something, but, and then we stopped meeting because everyone wants to do something big with a film needs budget.
Yeah.
For a budget, you need an actor who can pull in that crowd. I was not that guy. I did Yavade when Tarun, I met Tarun even before Yavade.
Okay.
When I did Yavade, Tarun felt like, he went around with his script to a bunch of actors and no one was coming ahead.
Okay.
And then he saw me and he was like, why should I not make it with a completely new guy?
Mm-hmm.
He can perform.
Okay.
So we met that way. It was effort from both our ends. So none of this magically happened, but you have to put the effort into making things happen. Pelli Chuppulu, I was telling someone else also today, Pelli Chuppulu completely happened because I read a book called Rebel Without a Crew by Robert Rodriguez.
Okay.
So he made a film called Desperado, which he made in $2,000.
Okay.
He would go and do medical tests. He had some money.
Oh.
So in a summer with some friends he met in a bar and all, he started shooting a film. Whenever he would run out of money, he would go, you know, they try injections, vaccines.
Yeah, tests.
Yeah, so he would go, give himself a test, make some money, shoot. And then when you have done a test, you can't go again to another test for a period.
Yeah, exactly.
Because it's bad for them, it's bad for him. But he would still risk it, go do it, make some more money. Like that, he finished the film. When it released, it became a rage. Then Hollywood funded him and made it in a big scale with Johnny Depp and Antonio Banderas and stuff. When I read all the things he did to make this film, I was like, how can you just sit and wait for things to happen? You need to make it happen.
Okay. It was the spark.
Yeah. So that book inspired me to, whatever happens, I believe in this director. I am going to make this film happen.
Okay.
And I believed in the story. We connected. I knew that it was a good film. So all of us, like Tarun, me, the heroine, cinematographer, none of us took remunerations for the film. We wrote a contract saying once the film makes money, you have to pay us. And we found two people who were ready, willing to put that money. We worked our ass off happily. made the film. So all this happened because we went out. I used to go sit with people, show Tarun's work and say, it's only going to cost 60 lakhs. You just put 30. I will get someone else to put 30. We will definitely make 1 crore at least you will make. So I would sit and do these sales pitch, would sit on promotion. It was really hard to do it. We faced lots of reject. After I made Pelli Chupalo, I took it to 4 to 5 of the biggest producers in Telugu. Everyone saw it and they walked away.
Okay.
They shook hands, they said good luck. They were like, I hope you do well. Out of good intention only, but okay. No one saw the potential in it.
Okay.
Once it released, it became the rage. And through these 4 or 5 rejections, every rejection kills you a little bit. Like then we would talk to each other like, no dude, we made a good film. People will like it.
Yeah.
We just have to stick through it. We just need to get one small release, we'll be sorted.
Mm.
So it was we went through lots of stuff. But the thing is, this is the journey that makes us capable that I will handle anything by myself.
Yeah.
It gives you the strength, you know how to handle everything by yourself. So this was a journey that taught me a lot, but so we had to make a lot of things happen throughout.
So I watched Pelli Chupalo and then there is Arjun Reddy.
Yeah.
First I heard the name.
Mm.
I was like, kind of, oh, why is this cast and all that? Why is Arjun Reddy, okay.
Some cast, cast all this.
Yeah, Reddy. Obviously. Oh, okay. Obviously. Yeah. I was so confused. But then it was like a rage there, you know. So
yeah.
The kiss scenes and all, you know, it was creating controversy in the media, in Telugu media. And it spilled over here.
Okay.
And then we went to the movie.
Okay.
It released in Chennai.
Okay.
Nobody really imagined, nobody really cared. First day. And then we were unable to buy tickets for the next 10-15 days, I guess. It became a rage. Forget about the rage. Still today, our guy was telling, 3 people, they have your DP, your face as a DP, and it's Arjun Reddy, not any other movie. Did you consider it as your lifetime magic, something, a lifetime film?
It's definitely a memorable film for me. It's a special film. It gave me respect from a lot of you. It made me reach out to a lot of places. It's a memorable film, but the thing is, I want 10 such memorable films. I don't want it to be the only film. I want to do films that make you even forget Arjun Reddy. I want to make both me and Sandeep, for example, we want to make a film that people will forget Arjun Reddy. People will think this is the film.
Mm.
You want to set bigger benchmarks, push yourself further. So, but it's a special film for me.
What is the best thing that you took from Arjun Reddy?
The admiration, man. Like, who gets this much love from the youth?
The best memory, that one memory, like, dude, what's happening?
Arjun Reddy premieres happened.
Mm.
I watched it. I went home. We went to the office. We sat for a long time speaking.
Okay.
I don't trust premieres. I said before the movie release, it'll be a blockbuster.
Okay.
But when I'm watching the film, people are screaming. I'm like, they're screaming because I'm here. I don't know if they like the movie or not. They're just screaming because the team is here. Because you get excited.
Yeah.
So I don't believe it. We were in office till 2-3 o'clock, then I went to sleep. I woke up at 12.
Okay.
My phone was getting, it was
hot.
Hanging.
Okay.
It was getting stuck because I'll see like 120 messages. By the time I open, there are 10 more coming. There are calls coming. And then I opened and I was just reading
okay.
various messages that friends,
okay.
Some critics there
okay.
had gone to the film and written.
Mm.
I was just reading and tears were flowing from my eyes. I don't remember what I read, but it just felt so emotional that something you put, that you believed in and you loved. I used to tell Sandeep, I like the film so much while we did it, after we did it. I was like, if people don't like this, I will go mad. As in, then I won't know what is good.
Yeah. Okay.
If what I think is beautiful, someone tells, I didn't like, then I'll be like, shit, I don't know anything. Then what do I do? I'll be lost. Sandeep was also like, dude, I'll go mad if people don't get it. Because I believed in it so much.
Okay.
So when I realized that my only fear was that something that I believe in so much, if people don't get it, what is my reference point? So my everything that I know is wrong. So when I saw these messages and such overwhelming messages, just tears started flowing. I just stayed there in bed for some time. And that's one memory. But the thing that I enjoy most is when I go into crowds, when I go into audience, when I go into my auditorium, when I just hear people shouting, it just re-energizes me. It feels like this is who you're putting this much. Because when you're working so hard, no, some days you feel like, wow, what is this so much? You're dealing with 100 different, everyone is creating an issue, someone is not doing their job, and everything is affecting you. And you're like, wow, how much do, what is this shit type? But when you go there and like, for this you're doing all this.
So you forget all the pain.
Yeah, you forget everything, it feels worth it. And then again, you get energy to go and push harder. So.
I saw you, there was a video wherein little children were playing with you and they were selecting scripts for you. It was such a nice video, it was such a heartwarming video. You know, maybe even if it is a lie, I don't mind. But then children selecting a video and then you selecting a script and you'll be saying, okay, let's go with this. What is the procedure for Vijay Devarakonda to select a script? Do you have any parameters like this box should tick and then I'll select a script and, you know, this is my next movie? Because becoming a star, there will be so many calculations in a regular normal world.
What I need to feel is when after I hear it, I just feel it's one sort of excitement to start. I feel like I want to be in this. I want to see myself in this story, in this character, and I feel multiple things. One thing is I feel like I want to be in this, not anyone else. I want to be in this. And then I feel like this is a film I enjoyed listening, this is a film I would enjoy watching, so I want to do it. So it just pulls you, man. There's something about a narration, something about a story that pulls you into it. Then there are some technical things that are beyond the script that I like to watch the director's work and like to spend some time, see the kind of vibe I'm getting with them, how they're reacting to stuff, how your conversation is flowing. There's some stuff beyond it, but it's basically the script. So that's how I select. I select from whatever comes to me.
Okay.
Because of the work I do, one type of film comes to me. It's because of the choices I make that more such films come to me. And a lot of what you become as an actor is what you say no to. What you say no to is more important than what you say yes to. Because so much work comes, so many 20-30 brands come to me to be the brand ambassador. But what I choose to do, what I say no to is more important.
Okay.
Like I don't believe in sodas, for example. I don't drink any of this aerated drinks.
Oh.
I don't drink, I don't let my friends drink.
Oh.
So when a brand like that comes, you say no. All this kind of defines what you become as a person. The kind of scripts you say, there are so many scripts that come. And so many of them get made. But why this Vijay Devarakonda you see is what I've said no to and the stuff that I've said yes to. So like these.
So you are gutsy enough to say a lot of no's. Have you made a lot of enemies?
I don't know, man. Like, I'm not aware of it. I feel like it's very simple. I like to keep things simple. Like, imagine Bharadwaj Rangan completely takes my case for some film. Tomorrow you might hate NOTA and completely dislike it. I'm very okay with it. It is work and it's your job to comment on the work.
Okay.
And I will still feel the same. What I need to like you for or not is beyond what you write. When I meet you, how I feel is what's important. So I feel even with scripts, it's never to a person.
Okay.
I'm not saying no. Very rarely you don't like someone. I'm like, I'll never work with this person.
Okay.
There are some people that I won't work with because just our energies, our behavior is very different. I'm not comfortable. But mostly it is just, this script is not working for me. We'll work on one more. if something else comes, it's a very, I think it's very simple. It should be simple.
Okay.
But I know the world doesn't work like that.
Mm.
But I think people understand that this guy is like this.
Okay. They and won't take it too personally. Yeah.
Even if they take it personally, I feel after some time they realize.
Yeah.
Mm. When you don't have any intention, negative intention, I think people will see it.
Okay.
Because even if I say no to someone, I don't feel guilty about seeing them. Mm. Because mm. I know it's not, I like you.
Yeah.
It's just a no to this.
Okay.
So when they see that I'm completely okay with it, they're like, okay, maybe things okay. are okay. So I can be true to myself. Like what I like, what I don't like, I can do. The rest, I think when you, yeah, one thing about being an actor, one hard thing is these obligations come up.
Yeah.
These I completely dislike so many. And still I say no. Like okay. so many of my producers come and say, obligation, can you appear here? Can you come to them? I'm like, no, sir, please, now wait a candy pan. I won't do all this. Leave me alone. I will just do my work, please. So I tell off mostly.
So these 3-4 films, you have somehow become a youth icon.
Mm.
Lot of youngsters are looking forward to your movies.
Mm.
They are inspired by you, mm. right or wrong, you know, they mm. are inspired by you.
Mm.
And the bad part is I see some people, mm. you know, getting addicted to drugs, addicted to alcohol, saying mm. that, this hero is doing that.
Mm.
It's not just limited to you,
mm.
particularly.
Yeah.
These heroes are doing it.
Mm.
They are doing it. This is mass. So we will also do it.
Oh.
Are you seeing in that angle, you know, should an actor be very concerned about what he does on screen? And should he be concerned about how it affects the youth?
See, we definitely, what all happens in my head, if I say it's very strange, but I was scared. First, I was scared that I hope this doesn't go wrong. Then I thought that, okay, but the film is this. So either I do this film or I don't.
Okay.
One thing, I can't do Arjun Reddy without all those. Then I might as well not do that film. Then I decided, let's do this film, but through my interviews and stuff, that is a character, but these interviews and stuff you convey to them
yeah.
through my personality, through the real me, that you don't smoke, smoking is not good and stuff. Now when it comes to these people being influenced,
mm.
what I realized is I can't influence them. We think that actors have the power to influence them. I have the power to influence only those who are willing
okay.
to. Like even if you go to a bar,
they need a reason and you become the reason.
Yeah, like even if I'm saying something good, like mm. I'm talking about, once there was a event in a college which was, I'm very concerned about cutting trees and saving water.
Okay.
I'm very scared that we'll run out of drinking pure water.
100%
which is
true.
Happening.
Yeah, true. Mm.
And when I brush, I open water, I close. I never leave tap running.
Okay.
I open water, close, brush, then I open it. I never open it full power because this was taught to me in school. So there was one big college conducting an event which was about the environment and saving water and stuff. I was feeling very strongly about it. I went. I'm talking about this. There is one segment of people who are like, "Hey, tell dialogue, Anna, you tell dialogue. Dialogue solo. But there is one set of audience who will listen to this.
Listening. Okay.
So I'm saying, even if I say something good, only if you want to listen, will you listen. So the choice of what you're influenced by is completely in your hand.
Okay.
Now, if I want to be influenced by something negative, not you, I will find it somewhere.
Okay. You'll find a reason.
I'll
yeah?
find a reason.
Hmm?
See, I have seen so many films which actors smoke, but I don't smoke in okay. real life.
Okay.
I have seen so many movies where actors do something really good also. They'll give their kidney for one friend, but I didn't give.
Yeah.
I will do according to what I believe in life, my environment,
mm.
the influence I have, the kind of personality I have. Films do have an impact. Films do have influence.
Yeah.
I'm not saying they don't.
Yeah.
But the thing is, we need to have the people need to have the willpower to choose what is good for them and bad.
Yeah.
because beyond it, like if I do a film where I take drugs, I will do a disclaimer saying don't do drugs. With the film, if you want, I will do.
Okay.
I will do it for free, saying don't do drugs, it's bad for you. This guy who is doing drugs, what do you think he will follow? It's his choice.
Yeah,
I'm doing
true.
Both.
True.
So I realize that you can't change people unless they want to be changed. They will do whatever they want.
True.
They will just associate it with different reasons that, or my friend got me into this habit or this or that, but it has to be your ethics, your nature, your identity, how you are as a person, your core will decide how you become.
You are talking about cutting trees, destroying nature and everything. Tamil Nadu record says that 30% of trees are gone. It's totally gone.
It's happening everywhere, man.
So, the core reason is politics, bad politics, and NOTA deals with politics.
Mm.
Are you concerned about the politics of this country? Because a whole bunch of money is resting with 5 to 10% of people.
Okay.
Rest 90 are without money.
Yeah.
They have the will to change this society. They have the will to plant trees. They have the will to, you know, refresh nature. You know, they have the will to redo this country and make it into a good one. But they don't have the time or the money. And the corporates or the guys, the bosses, they won't allow it to happen. Are you concerned about the current situation of India? What are we becoming as a society? Because you go to a lot of places throughout India. What are we becoming?
I don't know if it's as black and white as you're making it to be. See, because like saving water, we don't need money to save water. I just need to use in small quantities, not simply. One thing has to happen from the administration. Like the administration needs to encourage recycling of water. As in India, in the world, in so many places, in South Africa, for example, in Cape Town, it happened in Maharashtra, in Latur and stuff.
They ran out of water.
No water.
Not even a drop of water.
So everyone was getting 7 liters of water. In that water only, they were washing their vessels, just wiping their face. In the same water, wash their hands. So you just have 7-8 liters of water to do everything for an entire day. And when these people know that in our countries, to go to the bathroom we use fresh water, to flush we use fresh water.
Anything.
So I think administration wise and architecture wise, they need to say that the water that we are showering with only needs to go to the flush. Only when this water is not there. This is one design which the administration and establishment has to take.
Okay.
Now what we can do, we can make sure that we don't waste water, simply leave taps running, leave power running. We just wash cars with fresh water.
1,000 liters, 2,000 liters, it's gone.
We need to make sure that we save water ourselves. Planting trees it's not a very costly thing. But the damage of trees happens from corporates and governments on a big scale, because individually I can't go and cut trees. But the thing is, this is one loop. I also have been trying to think of a solution which I can't find, because once the world is revolving around money, people are not having the foresight to think about 10 years later.
Okay.
They're all thinking about now I need to make money.
Okay.
How do we make money quickly?
Exactly. Yeah.
So even for a politicians, what's happening is, if I don't make this road quickly for people, if there's to help traffic situation, I won't get votes.
Exactly.
So screw these 100 trees, but I need to win next election. And people are not patient enough to understand that this is better for our city, that the trees are there. So it is one, it's like one, did cock come first or egg come
first? Vicious cycle,
It's one cycle. So I think everyone needs to take our own initiative first. There is only so much the government can also do.
Mm-hmm.
Some governments are being good and proactive. But we need to stand up and ask questions.
Okay.
Whenever, like in Hyderabad, sometime when they wanted to cut trees, all the people stood up and said, there's KBR Park.
Okay.
So they were planning a corridor because there's so much traffic congestion around that area. they were planning a road to come over this to improve, but people said no, you cannot cut because that is the lung space. And the government is also trying to build alternative lung spaces. So they're all working, but it's like things add up also. Imagine you have 3-4 bad governments. Now it all falls in one, in 5 years. How do we improve this? Like Chennai, for example, was when you said you were from South India, they would call you Chennai.
Yeah.
Because Chennai was the biggest.
Exactly. Yeah.
South India's biggest city was Chennai.
Representation of South India, yes.
Was Chennai.
Yeah.
Now, why has Hyderabad and Bangalore grown beyond Chennai? If you come to Hyderabad and see the infrastructure,
it's
massive. The roads are big. The skyline has changed. I feel like Chennai's buildings and skyline has been the same since a long time.
True.
The roads are also still narrow.
True.
Why is it happening? So, and I heard people were scared to talk about in Hyderabad. Imagine a thing like Sterilite or something happens. People will not stand for it. Like, screw the government. People will become. But here, over time, they have, even here they stood up after Sterilite.
Yes.
But I'm saying they should. No one should have the guts to even do something
to
like.
To even that. Think about such
think
thing.
Think about what will happen if we do this. What will happen to our fate? They should feel so scared. So I think we should all stand. Now I see that people are openly discussing politics.
Yes. Yes.
In there, politicians get trolled majorly. If someone, be you the chief minister or the chief minister's son, you will get trolled.
Oh.
Yeah, so.
There is no fear.
There will be some amount of fear, definitely.
Okay.
But still, there is not so much fear that we can't.
Okay.
Like when Hyderabad roads are bad, I openly wrote, our roads are a joke. And I will get, there will be these
politics.
Strong party followers who will be like, you shouldn't. So they will be like, hey, what are you talking about, Argan? I'm talking.
Yeah.
I am from this from this state.
Mm-hmm.
I am paying taxes. I voted for this party. I want roads to be good. You should be able to have this constructive criticism. I will vote for whoever I feel is doing the best job. And if I vote and they don't know, I will openly ask them.
Yeah.
And if they are doing a good job, I might openly support them also. But it is important that this happens. Political situation of the country, I'm not completely aware.
Okay.
I know what is happening in my state, my neighboring state. Here I know because I'm spending so much time, I know. But how to bring this change from where? I think each of us needs to do a good job ourselves first.
Okay.
I see so many people littering, for example. Imagine I comment anything on Chennai. Or you comment anything on Hyderabad. Hyderabad people like, because we are like our city, our state.
Yeah. What do you know about that?
We are Tamil Nadu. We'll comment. But you will eat chips and throw, you'll drink water bottle and throw. For fighting everyone, all of us are ready to fight against each state, to fight against each city.
Yeah, true.
But are you taking care of your own city? So I feel like we don't feel like it's our home. Will we drink water bottle in our home and throw it like that? Or do in our home?
We treat it like a hotel, third place, someone's place.
Yeah, we are treating the city like it's someone will take care.
Yeah, true.
So unless we feel like this is our city, once we feel like that, we will have the confidence to question the government.
Yeah.
Whenever, if I don't litter every day and I see that the road is bad or something, I'll have the confidence. If I am throwing, I only won't have the confidence to question.
You will not even have the confidence to question.
Yeah, so I think all of us need to, very simple things. Let's wait till we go home and put it in. I put all my things in my car.
Oh.
And then when we go home, we clean it and put it. Either my driver does it, my assistant does it. If only I am there, I will do it.
Okay.
So I just put it in the car. All my staff, they don't litter.
Oh.
Because I have told them, if I see them littering, I said don't. So I can influence my immediate
change culture. Starts from you. Okay.
Yeah, because I do it, I tell them. If I tell them, hey, don't litter and tomorrow I am throwing something, they whatever I do, they will follow. How do kids learn? We see our
from the
so many
of
us vote the party that our father voted.
Yeah.
Because our father strongly voted, our behavior pattern, so many things I do subconsciously are what my father does.
Okay.
So we all learn from our surroundings. So I think we should do that.
Okay. is NOTA an outburst of all your thinking about this society? You know, you are so concerned about society. It's very happy. You know, I am very happy to see this from an actor. You know, how did NOTA happen? Are you really you want to convey some serious message to the society through it?
See, all of us have abused politicians.
Yeah.
As in, like, this fellow is useless. They are corrupt. They are doing this. They are not. And I used to feel like it's such a simple job. You have power. Just make sure this road is proper, no? Just make sure we have current. Just make sure it is clean. You are in the position. So when I heard NOTA, I feel like leading is such a common sense thing. But when I am doing cinema, I realize just for getting a film released only, how many power struggles, politics, strategy, so many things are happening. Somehow that's why I don't know if...
For a simple film release.
For a simple film release also, it's so complicated.
I see a lot of letters from your government side. For some films, they give special shows and all that.
Yeah, for some. Yeah, you can, that's based on your relationship with them, you get stuff. But also within, there's so much. So I feel like for a politician, it might be another level of struggle only. But NOTA, when I heard it, I was like, this is my answer to how. So simple, it's basic.
Okay.
Basic responsibility if you have. You can get things done. I'm not trying to give a message. But for me it is, I feel like if I was leading, this is how I would do it. This is how people should react. This is how things should be done.
Yeah.
Respond very quick. So NOTA is I think everybody who's complained about politicians or who's had this feeling towards politicians, or I think even every politician also needs to watch it. Need to watch it once and be like, they might think, this bugger boy, he'll tell nicely only, he should know what all we go through. Most of them will tell, but I think it's possible.
Okay.
Just need to have the, so I'm not trying to tell a message.
A suggestion maybe?
Yeah, I think they should watch it. They'll get some, they'll think.
So what made you select Anand Shankar? Because you are at the prime of your career and here comes a Tamil director trying to do a bilingual.
Yeah, I really liked the script. The character was something I haven't done before, so that excited me.
Okay.
A very real character again, put forcefully in a political situation. He's a very normal guy. And he's put in a political situation and how he reacts. So it is a true representation of if suddenly, so because we are all normal people, we comment on politics. But suddenly if tomorrow they dragged you and said you're leading the state for the next 1 month because of some scenario, how would you react? We don't
have no clue.
You'll have no clue, but things are happening, so you have to react. How you'll react? So all these things felt super interesting for me to do. I love the character, I love how the story flowed. And it's based on so many real incidents that have happened in Tamil Nadu and in Andhra.
Okay.
So I felt people need to see this.
Okay.
Because so many of those incidents have affected us.
Yeah.
So many of these things is leaders didn't do well. Leaders, the difference between a politician and political leader is this. That's why lot of them, we are not even calling them leaders, we are calling them politicians.
True.
Because they are only doing politics, they are not leading. So I feel like all these incidents are all so close that I found so ridiculous, that I found like, how did they let this happen? It made me angry.
Okay.
So I was like, I want to tell this story, I want to be a part of it. And Anand, I watched his two trailers.
Okay.
I didn't watch his films, but I watched Irumugan and Ariman Nambi's trailers. I really liked his storytelling style. He gave me a superb narration. He narrates, and I really liked him as a person.
Okay.
I like, chalo, I'll do it. And I wanted to do Tamil film, but I was saying no because I don't know the language. And I was like, there is a way I act, and for me to act in my way, I need to know everything. I can't think about the lines. How I'm talking to you now,
it has to come from you.
It has to come from me. I need to believe everything I say, only then I can perform.
Okay.
So I know if I don't know the language, how can I act? So I was saying no. But I liked the script, liked Anand, and I thought this film is so relevant for all of us. I decided, screw it, I'll learn the language while while acting. So I
on the go.
I told him you have to give me the script 1 month in advance.
Okay.
He was superb. He gave me the script 1 month in advance. I sat down, each word to word. I will put out the book once the film releases. I want to put out my book out.
Okay. How your preparation?
My preparation. So each word is translated into Telugu.
Oh.
Then I understood the meaning of each word that I said, and then we did it. So. And I was getting so much, like you said, Arjun Reddy, you didn't get tickets for 10.
Yeah.
Geetha Govindam, how people watched here. Pelli Chupulu was the first. Pelli Chupulu,
it ran for 100 days. Ran for 100 days in Lux.
Even here?
Yeah.
Oh shit, I didn't know this. I thought it ran for 30 days.
I saw it on the 85th day, something like that.
So people were like, why are people in Chennai? Everyone was shocked there. Why are they watching Pelli Chupulu, small film, even for AP Telangana?
Yeah.
Why are people in Chennai they're watching, in Bangalore they're watching? Then I was like, and then Arjun Reddy also, this happened, and I felt like I want to do something for them.
Okay.
And the only way, how do I show my love to so many people?
Mm.
By giving a film they feel connected to as well.
Mm.
So, and I can't, every film of mine, I want my Telugu audience also to see.
True.
So these guys were ready to make it in Telugu. He really wanted to work with me, Nyanvel Raja and Anand. They were like, I want to make with you.
Okay.
We'll make it in Telugu. Okay. But when I heard the script, I was like, the Tamil people have to see this. So then I said, I was really scared. I was really nervous before the first day of shoot coming, but the first day it flowed, and from then it was just smooth. So I'm super happy to have done this, and I think this is how I can say, like, not only the people, all the journalists here, you don't know how much you guys support me.
We celebrate you.
Yeah.
We don't support, we celebrate you.
Yeah, you guys.
You are not even here, but we celebrate you.
And I see all this, it reaches me, because my team says in Chennai, journalists just love you so much. And then I'm like, I need to do something. These people are so much they're doing for you. Mm. Without even, I haven't spoken to any of you.
Nothing.
I'm like, have to do something, otherwise it just feels, I have to show that, boss, I'm receiving your love and I'm grateful for it, and I will. You're taking so many steps towards me. This is one step towards you also, to show that I love you all and you also belong to me type. So I think I'm waiting, Marana waiting for you all to watch me perform in Tamil. And
one final question. There are so many youth watching you now, right now.
Hmm. Oh, is this live? Okay.
Now, it's now. Recorded. Yes, yes. You act. I prompt.
Okay.
Or I say take. You act. What's your message for them? You know, there are youth who are struggling. You know, they don't know where to go. Mm. They don't know where to start their careers.
Mm.
They are very depressed, disappointed.
Mm.
They are just on their cell phone.
Mm.
They want to become Arjun Reddy, they want to become Vijay Devarakonda, they want to become a top star, Amitabh Bachchan, but they don't know where to start.
See, the thing is, I don't want to be a youth icon. I don't think I'm an idol. I'm not an idol, I'm not an icon. I'm a normal guy, I'm very flawed. I make so many mistakes and I don't follow anyone. No one can tell me, Vijay, do this, do that. Why I fight for what I'm fighting is, I want proper food, I want respect, I want people to acknowledge me, give me respect, I want money, I want comfort for myself, for my mother, for my dad, for my brother, for whoever I marry, for my friends. So if survival and respect can't motivate anyone, who am I to motivate? They are such bigger emotions. So if survival is not motivating you enough, there is no message I can give that can help anyone. Your best interest should motivate anybody. Me giving advice is just me trying to say something, but you should find the motivation within you, to find the respect, to find money, earn money, have a good life. We have one life, might as well do whatever we can to live it nicely.
Yeah, yeah.
Like if I want to eat biryani today, I should be able to eat. If I want to drink a beer, I should be able to drink. If I want to go out with my friends and watch a film, go on a holiday, I should be like, aray, I don't have enough money this time. I have had days like that where I couldn't go with my friends because I didn't have money. I couldn't go on a holiday trip because I didn't have money. I didn't do so many things because I was like, I don't want to trouble my parents right now. Okay. But I want to do all those things. So that drove me. I never want to not be able to do anything, because I feel like we all have hands, legs, brain. All of us have. I feel like God gave us all like 1 acre of land. This is my analogy. It could be wrong.
Okay.
I feel all of us have 1 acre of land. Now it is up to you if you will just sit there and sleep, or you will build one small hut and live, or you will build one hotel and sell food and make money and live, or you will build one restaurant, or you will build one temple and pray. What you do with this ability is up to you. And life is never fair. It was not fair for me, it is not fair. That's the way of nature. There will never be equal opportunity, it will never be fair. But because it is the way it is, you will work harder. You have to work harder. I have to do 10 times what a star has to do to achieve the respect I have. Like, I have to work double hard, I have to show much bigger success to achieve the same amount of acknowledgement or respect of what is. But I have to do it, that's all. I'm not complaining. I have to do it, I'll do it. That's the way of the world. My son will have to work much lesser than me. That's his luxury. But that's the way of the world, and we have to. There's no point complaining, is what I feel.
Yeah.
Just have to work our ass off. Complain, but complain in your bedroom to your mother or wife, but come out and work.
Yeah.
If you complain and give up, it's pointless. Yeah.
Kadasiya, Natchin or Tamil dialogue from NOTA.
Na NOTA dialogue solunga na plot reveal.
Sir, you say something in Tamil. One sentence,
anything,
two sentence, sharp.
One, two sentence, sir.
Come on. You can do it.
I can. I just have to think of the words before I say it. Tamil industry ki vandu, which means I came,
yeah.
Coming, vandu.
Varren. Yeah.
Na Tamil industry ki varren. Romba santoshama irukku. Unga ellariyum October 5th na theater la meet panna poren
FDFS varuven
FD
morning early morning show unga kuda paaka poren
early morning show unga kuda paaka poren cinema paarenga or enjoy pannunga romba nalla experience irukku October 5th na ennoda padam NOTA Tamil Nadoda
எல்லா இடத்துலையும் ரிலீஸ் ஆக போகுது
ஃபுல்லாக என்ஜாய் பண்ணுங்க. அவர் உங்கள் அன்பு
எனக்கு என்றைக்கும் வேணும்
வணக்கம், நன்றி.
தேங்க்யூ பிரதர், தேங்க்யூ ஃபார் பீயிங் சச் எ வண்டர்ஃபுல்.
தேங்க்யூ ஸோ மச் பிரசாந்த்.